All right, so I think over the years, open source technology has gone a long way. In the meantime, enterprises around the world and also in Brazil have recognized that they actually can rely on open source software, open source innovation in an enterprise mission critical context. Obviously, the most prominent example is maybe Enterprise Linux, where customers in Brazil and elsewhere in the world run truly mission-critical, very important workloads and business processes on open source technology on Linux. And that means that open source and Linux is today a reality in the enterprise data center. And that also means that vendors, whether they're open source vendors or closed source vendors, have realized that they have to follow the demand of those enterprise customers. Mixed IT is a reality for them. Enterprise customers made a vote, right? They want to participate in open source innovation. They want to deploy open source technology as well as they want to deploy a closed source technology as well. So that means that over the years, the commercial open source vendors and the closed source vendors actually found a way to operate with each other. We support each other, we support certain standards. We in many cases actually collaborate with each other to make best of breed combined solutions usable in an enterprise context.
But that wasn't something that proprietary software gave up easily, isn't it?
No, initially there was, especially in the early stages, there was maybe more of a competition going on. There's still competition going on, right? We are still fighting for the same workloads, for the same servers. But over the years, actually, also the closed source vendors realized the power of open source. They also realized that open source is a force that is unstoppable. In many cases, they also realized that they can use open source to their advantage. So there's actually closed source vendors that engage in open source projects and contribute to the innovation and the optimization of those solutions. A very prominent example of that would be OpenStack, right? The open source project to build a cloud infrastructure. There's many open source vendors contributing to the innovation, but there's actually also closed source proprietary vendors that participate and help this project to be successful. So it's a true synergy, joining force in many cases.
So it was a huge step, or I mean lots of small steps from open source. And in this actual environment, how is SUSE positioned in this environment of open source now a reality, as you said?
Yes. So SUSE is, and some people might know, not everybody might know it, is one of the true open source pioneers in the industry. You should remember that open source emerged around Linux as an additional operating system in the early 90s, 1991. And SUSE, as a vendor, started to build a business around open source, engaging with the Linux communities, engaging in the open source innovation model, and then take the technology to make it enterprise usable, enterprise quality, enterprise security, enterprise scalability already in 1992. So we have been there all the way long. So that means today, yes, we are participating in the trend because we know how open source works. We engage and support with the communities. We contribute to the communities. We respect the power of the communities. And then we take the innovation that we develop together, harden, secure it, and provide high quality service and support so that enterprise customers can really utilize that. That's true for Linux. That's true for private cloud infrastructure based on OpenStack, but that's also true for new solutions in the area of software-defined infrastructure. Also, there's a lot of open source solutions emerging. The most prominent example for SUSE is software-defined scalable storage, where we also have a solution called SUSE Enterprise Storage, which allows customers to build storage clusters to store massive amount of data on commodity hardware clusters at a fraction of the normal price. So yes, we are participating in the acceptance of open source by enterprise customers because we are one of their primary partners to help them utilize and get success out of open source in the enterprise data center.
And is do you think this history of success, we also saw it here in Brazil, do you think Brazil is relevant nowadays in this market?
Oh, very relevant. So first of all, for me personally, it's relevant because in Latin America, Brazil is my biggest market. Actually, two-thirds of my Latin American revenue is coming from Brazil, so a very important market for me. And the market is also growing. It's actually growing faster than some other markets in the rest of the world. Brazilian enterprise customers and also the Brazilian government have always been pretty acceptive and supportive to the open source idea, to the open source communities. So we definitely see many enterprise customers from different verticals, whether it's the finance sector, whether it's production, whether it's the pharmaceutical or chemical sector, whether it's the government, we see many enterprise customers that rely on open source technology. So with regards to that, the market is growing for me personally. I see high degrees of open source adoption in the Brazilian market. And while I'm here, I'm obviously not talking just with the press, but I'm also visiting enterprise customers in Brazil, and I was truly, truly impressed by the degree of any innovation that many of those enterprises were driving in the context of digitalizing their business, right? Embracing maybe the cloud, the private cloud, the public cloud, embracing software-defined infrastructure, storage, but also software-defined networking, embracing big data solutions like Hadoop, engaging in real-time analytics of big data to develop their business faster. And in many cases, they saw the power of open source innovation and used open source innovation to drive those trends in their own enterprise. So the answer clearly is yes, open source is big in Brazil and has been big for many years.
Do you see a maturity of the companies, the use they make of the technology and the opportunities?
Both, actually. So I see some of the enterprises that use, let's say, Enterprise Linux, which is pretty much a very stable and maturing technology, right? And they do that. But I was very impressed with a couple of highly sophisticated future strategies that enterprises here develop and start to implement around the combination of private and public cloud, hybrid cloud strategies. So companies that had a very well-defined strategy on developing their private cloud infrastructure solution, but then also reaching out to the public cloud and not just embracing one public cloud service provider, but orchestrating the use of different public cloud service providers so that they can scale in and out, but also scale out to different public cloud service providers, which is very, very sophisticated way of usage. So what I try to tell you is while I was here, I have seen some truly innovative concepts that Brazilian enterprise customers are embracing today.
This kind of flexibility, and you, as you mentioned, the company can choose, I can go this way, but I can come back and choose another way. This is kind of the proposition of open source, isn't it?
That is the proposition of cloud computing, right? That's the end state of cloud computing, to give you the ultimate flexibility to move workloads, computing requirements, data storage requirements around, right? To the public cloud, maybe some of the things you preserve to have on your on-premise in your own data center in something like a private cloud technology setup. That's the ultimate outcome and best promise and most effective use of cloud technology for enterprise customers. Yes.
And do you think we have came across this idea that open source is like free software? Do you think the consumers have matured in this way also?
Yeah. No, I would say that enterprise customers certainly understand the difference, right? So what they like about open source is, so first of all, they realize that the open source communities, because it combines so many different contributors, people that join the community to develop a product, to develop a technology, to innovate a technology. It can be vendors, can be customers, can be technology partners, sometimes people from universities, sometimes people from public institutions, all come together and share the effort to innovate in a collaborative effort, right? So, and enterprise customers like that because they can participate. A, they have full transparency what's going on because it's not like closed software development behind the curtains or behind the walls of an enterprise.
So
they can see what's happening, no black box. They can influence, if they want, also what is happening, which gives them more inclusion in the process, gives them more ability to influence, gives us less dependency on just one vendor solution, less lock-in. They realize that this way of collaborating also decreases time to market, so makes time to market faster because so many people shoulder the effort, right? and that also brings down the cost to market of new technologies in many ways. So they take benefit of the inclusive nature, of the openness, of the transparency, of the fast and rapid innovation and time to market. And in many cases, open source is a very cost-effective alternative to the more traditional closed source solutions, proprietary hardware and software solutions. Okay. However, open source is not for free. Okay, because the you don't have to buy a license. The technology is for free, but as an enterprise customer, you want to deploy it and run your best business processes on it. And you need to be sure that they're always running, that they're always secure. And for that, you need partners that provide service and support. Those partners that help you to innovate the code, those partners that help you to get security fixes, updates, patches, that you can call and say, hey, now I have a problem, and now you have to fix it for me really fast because my customers are waiting for me to provide that service, right? And for that, you cannot just rely on the community. For that, you need to engage with a commercial open source vendor like SUSE, who actually accepts that responsibility and delivers that service to you. And yes, you pay a fee for that. So for that reason,
there's still a business time that needs to be addressed.
But seriously, enterprise customers, they understand that concept. So they are not confused about that. So.